Hey, you crazy bunch of bananas, and welcome back to the World of Madness. We are back on the server to finish off the Santa project. We did the Christmas tree in the last video. If you haven't seen that, I strongly suggest you go check it out. It's a really nice tree. I won't be showing it in this video, so if you want to see it, okay, maybe I will. But if you want to see it anyway, go and check out the video. It'll be linked in the description, as probably well as on screen somewhere. Anyway, guys, so today we are going to be adding some redstone to this lovely Satan Claus, although we will need to change the design a little bit to make it work. So I'm really sorry to Sneaky who built this, but if you want some redstone in it, we're going to have to change some things out. So what I want is for this guy to give us presents when you give him a diamond. Yes, he is a Satan Claus, so he only gives you presents if you pay him. So what I've done, I've dug out all the section I'll need underneath. We're going to have a chest in his hand right here that you can give him the loot. And then his mouth will open, his eyes will change, and an item will pop out. That is the goal anyway. That's the goal of this video. So it's similar to how I did the Witch's Hut, but this time we're going to use shulker boxes so we get a little bit of the extra presence. I've got a bunch of shulker boxes somewhere on me. There we go. A bunch of shulker boxes here, all ready to go, as well as a load of good items, which are all like the presents you can get, and the bad items like Curse of Vanishing, Curse of Binding, all like stuff that you don't really need, like Bane of the Wrath Bunch. You're getting a diamond sword, but it's got a terrible enchantment, or coal, as the usual stuff is, or a smite, which is just, why would you want to? So, we've got some pretty cool enchants and some pretty bad ones as well, so you're going to be like, you know, look at the draw. You might get something good, you might get something bad. It depends on how good or bad you have been. So that is the goal today. So first things first, I need to lay out all of the redstone, so I will be right back once I've pretty much sorted out the structure of where everything's going to go. This is going to be a very tight fit. Okay, so we should have the activation sorted now, so we press that. It opens and it drops out of prison. So it's working as far as I can tell. So we've got repeaters going into three pistons there, sticky pistons, and then a dispenser with all the items in. It's going to be really simple to work this, so you press that. So when that activates, these turn off, that turns off, and then we're good to go. Now we've got the eyes to sort out as well. So what the eyes are going to do, the eyes are going to flip in, they're going to change into the redstone lamps, they're going to glow like a demonic sort of monster, and then they're going to go back into normal. So that is the goal on this one. I just, hopefully, we'll be able to work out the redstone. I don't really know what I'm supposed to do with it, but we'll figure it out as we go along. Wish me luck. So we're going to need a double piston extender on two sides to take out this block right here. We're also going to change these yellow bits to red. I'm really sorry, Snakey. It doesn't work unless it's red. Okay, and then we are going to have a sticky piston coming down with the redstone lamp in it. And then another one this side with redstone lamp in it as well. Which means they'll come down, drop in the block, and we're good to go. We also need to change these two here to be redstone blocks. So if we take those and put those there, we should, oh, not that one. The problem with manic mining here is it's really quick mining and I'm not used to it. So there and then there. All right, cool. So now we just need to set up the old piston extender. So what we're going to do is put a redstone two repeaters, and then redstone right there and there, followed by this line here, and I believe it is 4 ticks and 2 ticks. So there and there. Let me just double check that. That's right, 4 ticks and 2 ticks. So then we're gonna put a repeater right here, if I can place it. So I just need to come back, da-da, right there. And that now has the double piston extender. Perfect. Now, if we were to turn this off with a button, let's just double check. So put a button on the side, turn it off, blocks come back. Blocks go forward. Blocks come back. Blocks go forward. Absolutely perfect. Yay, I like it when it works. Alright, so now I got that. We're just going to make these drop down with the redstone lamps. Okay, so using a circuit sent in to me by Lion and Bedmon, so a massive thank you to Lion and Bedmon for this circuit right here. I actually haven't got a clue what it's called. He did say the name of it, but I forgot it already. So if it doesn't work, I'm blaming him. But basically, the redstone torches turn on just enough time to push this down, and then they retract quick enough so that this can be pushed back out. So I don't know what it's called, but thank you, Lion and Bedmon, for sending it in. It is a massive help. So we press this button. They go down. And they retract. Did that work on the other one? It did. Cool. We've got a working system. So blocks come out, those go down and back up. Perfect. Oh, yes. So you got a redstone dust up there. You got a repeater up there set to one tick, sorry. So one tick repeater right there. Then a four, then a two right here with two torches on the east side. So then what basically happens is this torch turns off, turning the power off on this line right here, turning this torch back on, but quite quickly afterwards, it turns it off with that one there. So it's a really nice little circuit. And if I press it again, you'll see it turns on, then turns off straight away. So this delay here doesn't turn that off. So it's a really nice little circuit. On and then off. Perfect. Absolutely what I'm after. Thank you so much to Line and Bedman for that. It's been a while since I've done redstone, so I'm on command blocks these days. So when it came to redstone, I was like, I haven't got a clue what I'm doing. So once again, a massive thank you to Lion and Bedmon. You have saved my bacon with this contraption right here. So now that we've got the mouth working and the eyes working, we just need to work on the item system. So when the player puts an item in the hand, all this gets activated. We'll also need a little bit of a pulse extender as well. So I'll work on that next, I think. Oh no, I'll work on the delivery system first. So here we have the item sorter. It's a really simple system. We've got a bunch of hoppers coming down into this hopper right here with a diamond, and then a bunch of renamed cobblestone with a secret name so people can't fudge the system. Then when the items get filtered out of there, they send a signal through this comparator, making this one more longer than it needs to be, sending a redstone signal through this repeater into that torch and unlocking this hopper so the items go into this chest here. It's a really simple system. We also have the output right here as well, so we can take a redstone signal from here, or we could take the signal from here. The option is there for us. I might actually take it from there, given that it'll mean that I can keep things nice and lined up. So we might take it from there, but we can take it from there as well. So if I put an item into this chest right here, you'll see that light goes on. If I do actually from here, I'll probably see a bit easier, so do that and it goes on. But if I put a cobblestone in, nothing happens. It goes into this chest here, so it goes filters straight into that chest if it's not the item I'm looking for. But if it's a diamond, it goes into that chest there, and there should be one right in there as well, because always seems one gets locked in there. Just very slightly gets locked in there. It's fine. It works. Anyway, guys, so that is the item sorter. Now I just need to work on all of the music notes, because I want this thing to make sounds. Because, you know what? It's Christmas. Why not? Actually, before we sort out the music notes, we need to make sure that the chest is taking in items. So what we're going to do is use a hopper minecart, because that is probably the easiest way of doing this, and to make it look like at least pretty afterwards. So we're going to place a minecart rail like that, put our minecart in it like that, break the minecart rail like that, perfect, and then try and get the item in there. So I want to get the minecart into that hole without actually taking up too much space. So let's get some... Where did I put the wood for the floor? There it is. Okay, cool. So we can place that there. Perfect. So we can push this in a little bit. No, it's going to keep pushing off that block. Okay, what if we do that and then just slightly touch it. Stop. Perfect. Right. Now we just need to place pistons on top of this thing. Okay, so to get the blocks back in. So if we do... how am I going to do this? If I do... it from above, probably from above would be the easiest way. So let's just place some blocks like that, then a piston facing down. Probably gonna need two. I want to think about it. All right, so let's do that again. So take away that, give me it back. Yep, it's gone underneath. Gotta go get it. Okay, so rock there, and then the bone block there. And then on this bit, we're going to need to put in the red sandstone. So we'll do that afterwards. So hopefully this will work. If we take a redstone torch, place it here, I guess. There we go. That puts that into that block there. And then we just need to move everything over. So break that. Please say I picked up. I did. And then break that. Then place it... right here, I guess. Yep, right there. And need to break one. Break it down a little bit. Place the piston there. And then two redstone right there. And we should be golden, I think. There we go. Right, cool. So that means that the hopper minecart is lovely hidden away inside of this area right here. Now I just need to play a chest on top, which we can have the present chest right there. And now if we put anything in here, it should go straight into the pistons below. Perfect. I love when things work. Okay, so the nub blocks are all placed down, and if we press this button, it clearly sounds nothing like Jingle Bells, but that is because we need to do the timing. So, we have all the timing set up on these guys, but we just need to set the actual tone up. So, hopefully I remember which one it is. So, I think it's, remember, it's 1, 2, 3. Then, no wait, 4. So that'd be 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I think it's 4 again? Let's try it, see what it sounds like so far. Close. So we went in ding, so it's 7. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0 on that one, and then 1, 2. Then, oh wait, no, that was supposed to be 0. Ah, no. Break and replace. There we go. Place. There we go. So that one's supposed to be 0. So that's 0. 1, 2, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's try this out. This should sound like Jingle Bells. Oh, nowhere near. Right. Well, it's kind of close. Right. I actually don't know what I've done wrong here. Let's just break these so we go back to 0. I might have too many notebooks here. I don't actually know. Right. Let's try this out. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Right. So we're after this long one here, which is a 5, which should be 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0. 1, 2, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. I got a little bit mixed up. Okay, so we press this now. Perfect! Yes! That is Jingle Bells right there. Oh, wow. So much work just to get a simple, we need a GUI for these things. Like, you should be able to right-click it and then see what the note is and place the note. That should be a thing. Mojang, get onto it. Alright, so now this is done. We just need to hook this into the mouth. And then this into the eyes, because they're totally separate systems. Oy vey. So, because I need this here to create a longer pulse, we're going to need a pulse extender. Now, there is a few out there on the internet that you could use. I'm going to use a very simple one that I kind of like the look of. And it's nice and compact as well, which is really useful for this build. So, let's get rid of that, because we put it in the wrong place. Put that on there, like that. Place a redstone block on top of that. And then we get rid of the block underneath. This is going to be our output right here. So we'll place blocks down there just so we know where the output is. It's going to need a comparator right on that block there, which we do have with us. Perfect. Place it on there. That's our output right there from this hopper right there. Then we need to have a signal going into that block there. This here needs to be 1 over. I made it in the wrong place. So that needs to go right there. We place a piston on this side there with a block on top. Then we want to put a torch right there with a redstone there. And then another repeater right there. And I think that should be it. Now if we put some items in there, or a item in there, or maybe a few items in there then. There we go. Okay. So this is now a pulse extender. So when this gets to a full amount, or when this gets to empty, this will turn back on, which then will push this out in a one tick pulse like that, leaving the block where we need it to be. Then the items will filter back from that one into this one. So basically making an extended pulse. So this one, this repair comparator right here, will be on for a lot longer from one input signal, a one tick input. So for that, we're going to need this to be not that long, maybe around about 7 blocks. We should have probably waited for that, but okay, so 7 blocks of length. And then we're going to take the output from here on a repeater. So we got like an extra signal right there. And then feed that into a line going straight up into that block right there. Which, or is it that block right there? It's that one right there. Oh boy. And there we have it. Could it look prettier? Probably. Could it be more compact? Most definitely. But does it work? That's the question. So without further ado, let's go back up to the top and have the inaugural chest of this thing. Just see if it works in general. I really hope it does. So you place a diamond in here, and then this should... It works! And then that should close. Perfect! Oh my god, it actually works. I'm speechless. I am actually surprised that worked so quickly. Perfect. Okay, so basically, anything goes in there, this thing will work as long as there's a diamond. Put that in there, nothing gonna happen. But if we put a diamond in there... We get an item. That is perfect. I am so happy with the way that worked out. Oh my god, I'm so surprised it actually worked. Right, so now I just need to hide up all the stuff on the sides here. Stuff that isn't really meant to be seen, like the pistons and whatnot. We'll just give them a bigger hat. That fixes that. And we're good to go. Everything should be working. And I should probably maybe fix this hole in the back of the mountain as well. That's an idea. So here are all the presents for this lovely Satan Santa. We've got good presents like some Ender Pearls, some ultimate fireworks and Lytra, and a joke, a dyslexic man walks into a bra. Yes, I can make that joke, I'm dyslexic. So there's a bunch of little crisp crack jokes in there as well. You've got some bad stuff like coal and Aqua Infinity Protection 3 and Curse of Binding. So once you wear that, you're stuck with it. But there's all these ones here are bad and all the ones there are good. So hopefully a mixed variety, a good mixed variety. So now we just need to put them in the system and we're ready to go. Now we just need to mix them up. So we're going to put them inside this custom crafter here and just place them in and then randomly click like that. Then once again do that. So I want it to be as random as I can possibly make it. Obviously the dropper will make it a little bit more random, but for now I just need to get all them mixed up. So I haven't got a clue which one is which. And now we put them into this hopper here, so I'll just do that. Let them filter out. And that should be full. Yep, we're left with one. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so that is it. We have a Satan Santa that should actually work. So let's give it one little test over just to make sure everything's running smoothly. I know I can trust my redstone, but sometimes, you know, I haven't done it for a while, so... And what do we get? We got a good present. Oh, nice one. We got a Shulker Ender Guardian. That is really good. Okay, so it's actually working perfectly. So either you've been good, you've been bad, you don't know what you're going to get off Satan Santa, but what you do know is you're going to have to pay for it. And that is one singular diamond to get something which could potentially be pretty damn cool. An Ender Guardian head is pretty damn rare. And a cracker joke, which is, what do you call bears with no ears? I don't know. B. Ah, the jokes. The jokes. So anyway guys, that is it for this week's World of Madness. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, like, much appreciated. It helps the channel a load. And until next time, TTYL. Peace out. Yum. Bye-bye. See you all in 2018. Ah, it's going to be cool and awesome. We're going to have more videos and more awesome things going to be happening on the server. I guarantee it. We've got a bunch of farms to make as well. Iron Golem farms. Let's make minions out of Iron Golems.